So when I created the original video 5 years ago, I got a lot of feedback that the screen recording was not clear enough for people to understand. So anyway, today's video is a recreation of that older video. Hopefully this time the screen recording is clear because I'm using a different software. And also, I was getting a lot of comments. Can you show this in MS Project 2016? Some people have comments that the formula was giving error. I received a lot of feedback that the formula did not work at summary task level. So I'm gonna show it today. So nothing changed from a formula or step perspective. I'm gonna show it today so you guys can follow along with me and understand what exactly you need to know. So I'm just gonna create a new simple project. Let's open a blank project. We will set the project start date today's first, so let me go back to a Monday, 22nd. We'll create a 2 week project starting October 22nd. And the current date is set. So that's set under the project information section. We call it a 2 week project. Week one, we have day one, day two, day three, day four, day five. So I'm just gonna copy for the second week and paste it. And we call the second week as week two. All this is part of the 2 week project. So under task, I'm gonna intend it. And then the first 5 days goes under week one. And the second 5 days goes under week two. All this has 1 day duration. So I'm just gonna select all that, go to information and say duration is 1 day. I'm also gonna link all this task. So click on the link. So it's sequentially followed one after another. So that is just to keep things simple. And now we have the basic project structure. So before we go into next projects and copy the formula, one thing to ensure is that you have baselined the project. So I'm gonna go to project and set baseline. This is very critical because all the calculations are done based on the baseline dates. So just make sure you baseline the project, because I'm just gonna exactly mimic what you guys are gonna do, copy pasting the formula, right? I just wanna show that the formula works, whether it's MS Project 2010, 2013, or 2016. It's all the same. I have not changed anything. And I just wanna show you as is so that you guys can follow along. I think the previous video was not clear enough from a screen capture perspective. So I'm not gonna explain the details put in here. I'm just gonna make it faster, copy paste the formula, and as I do, I'm gonna explain you all these things. So how to do it and the formula. So in order to do it, you need to basically create a new column, number as the format, and call it as duration in days. And then I'm just gonna copy paste this, copy, go to the project, and then we said we want a new column called number. I'm gonna right click, click on custom fields, rename. We said we wanna call it as duration in days, and click on formula radio button, and then just copy paste the formula and click OK. and then OK. So we just completed the step one, right? So, you know, whatever you are seeing in duration in days should match to what you have here. Because if you change this to 2 days, it should automatically change to two. And the summary also should show six instead of zero. So I'm gonna change it back to one. The reason it did not change is because we did not apply the formula for the summary task. So you can go back to custom fields, and then we did the formula, but then you have to ensure that you are using the formula for the summary rows. So click on use formula and then click OK. Now you can see the summary task also has the formula applied, so it matches to the duration on the MS project. So duration in MS project is stored as in minutes. Even though it displays here as days, it is actually stored in minutes, and that's the reason why we have to copy paste the formula and convert into days. So this is the formula to convert the duration, which is stored natively in minutes, into days. So that's all what this step is. Now if you go back to the website, the step two is to calculate the elapsed days. So again, we have to insert a new number two column, call it elapsed days, and copy paste this formula. So this is where most of you were getting error, as I get a lot of feedback that this formula is not working. So just watch carefully here and you can see what error I'm getting and how you can resolve it. So I'm gonna copy the formula and we'll select a new column for number two and rename it as elapsed days. So go to the MS project, right click, number, insert a new number column. I'm gonna go to custom fields, rename it as elapsed days, click OK, and then come to formula, click the formula button, just paste it and click OK. So here I also got the error that the formula has some issue. So click OK, and what it does is, it's not the error in the syntax, but for some reason you just have to retype, you know, where the error is highlighted. So click on that, just retype the same thing, click OK, and it works, and click OK. Now here is where you see error, right? So the reason you're seeing error is now it is calculating the elapsed days and it doesn't have a reference. It doesn't know what is my reference point. So what I mean by that is, if you go to project information, you have to set the status date. So by default it's not applicable, so just choose today's date. So today is November 1st for me. I'm clicking on that, click OK. Now you see the elapsed days column is showing up. Again, it's not working at the summary task level. So again, right click, go to custom fields, and under the summary rows option, use formula. And that should take care of it. So what it is doing is, it is comparing your baseline date and calculating how many days is already over, right? So today's November 1st, so it's stating that we have completed 9 days of the project, because it's November 1st and it's gonna end on 2nd. So as per the planned dates, we already consumed 9 days. So that's what this column is. Now we are done with the second step, right? So at any point you can go back and say, okay, let me calculate the elapsed days as of, let's say, October 23rd. It should be only 2 days, right? So you click on the status date, and if you say it's today is October 23rd, you see the elapsed days is going back to 2 days. So that's how it is calculating the elapsed dates based on the status date. So just make sure that you are setting the status date right to have the calculations correctly. Now going back to website for the final step, which is step number 3, not the final step. So here we are actually calculating the planned percentage complete. So again, the formula is simple, number 2 divided by number 1. Insert a new column called number 3, just rename it, go to custom fields, rename as planned percentage, okay. Click the formula radio button, click formula and say, you can copy paste by the way, I'm just gonna type number 2 divided by number 1. Okay, and then apply to summary row. Okay, and now you have the planned percentage complete. So it's saying it's 90% complete. The actual percentage may not be 90, but this is what we are calculating, right? If we would have followed the planned baseline dates, what percentage should the project be in at certain date? Now the next and last final step is just to format this into a percentage type of field. So it has to be a text, so I'm gonna click that. Okay, and coming back to the website, it's a text, we are calling it as plan percentage complete, and then copy paste the formula, copy, and then go here and then paste it. Right click, custom fields, formula, and then paste it. Okay, okay. Again, it's showing me an error. So you just have to delete that portion and retype the same thing. There's nothing wrong with the formula. For some reason, it doesn't take when you copy paste. So just retype it and say use formula for summary rows and click OK. And there you have it. So once you have this, you can always rename it. What did we call in here as planned percentage complete? Just copy that and right click, custom fields, rename, paste, okay, and okay. So this is what we were calculating manually, right? And the column that is available in MS Project is the percentage complete. So you go back to, let's say this is as of 23rd, right? You go back to the project information, click on the status date, and let's say as of 23rd, October 23rd. Ideally, we should have completed 40%, but we have only finished 34%, so we are running behind. But there could be chances that some, let's say, if this did not have any dependency on, you know, number 7, and let's say he finished this 100%, right? So if you look at the overall percentage for the project, as of 23rd, you were only planned to finish 20%. So we actually finished 27%, right? So that's where you can see the actual value. Even though from a date perspective, it may not be aligning to what you complete versus what you planned, but at your overall project perspective, you are actually ahead of schedule because you have completed some tasks that are not scheduled to start until certain date, right? So just wanted to show this example Once you have this column defined, you can right click and hide all this. So you have this plan percentage versus actual percentage complete. So at any point of time, you can compare what was supposed to be the percentage complete if you would have followed the plan dates against the actual percentage complete. So I hope this helped you guys, and if you like this video, give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel for more videos like this. All right, take care guys.